This episode is brought to you by CuriosityStream, a subscription streaming service that offers over 2,000 documentaries and nonfiction titles. Unlimited access starting at just $2.99 a month and 30 days for free if you sign up at curiositystream.com/TopTenz. Use the code TopTenz. More on them in a bit. Ever since man looked up at the stars, he has been fascinated by the big, round, white hunk of rock that hangs in the sky above us. The moon has featured in religious beliefs and in the love of countless cultures and societies. Due to human curiosity, we set out to understand the moon further, and what we have learned is sometimes even more interesting than the legends themselves. Join us in the video today as we explore our moon and revel in its glory. Number 10. Helium III. Many people, upon hearing that countries still plan to return to the moon, often wonder why. Some people don't really think much of a big hunk of dull rock that isn't even made of cheese. However, the moon has something much more valuable than stale cheese underneath the surface. Enter helium-3, a lightweight isotope that could single-handedly fix our energy problems. Helium-3 can be used in nuclear fusion, sans the radioactivity, making it a way safer process. This isotope has already been tested and has been found to be incredibly efficient. While mining it would be extremely expensive, the costs would be well worth the gain. Imagine a future with safe, affordable, clean energy for the entire world. Number 9. Water. These days, scientists are on a roll finding all kinds of new things, and the moon has been no exception. While many people would suggest all kinds of strange things that could be on the surface of the moon, such as extraterrestrial beings or maybe all those socks you lose in the washing machine, what scientists actually found is much more surprising. Using remote imaging, scientists scanned the crater Bulialdus near the equator of the moon and found water molecules locked in the rocks deep below the surface. Found beneath the surface, it is referred to as magmatic water and is thought by scientists to have originated due to solar winds that impacted the surface of the moon. Number 8. Preserved footprints. As you know, our moon doesn't really have much in the way of an atmosphere, but what you may not realize is that this has some very interesting implications. Namely, things don't erode very easily, so the footprints left by US astronauts in the 60s and 70s are still preserved, and should be so for a long time. The unique situation has given a brand new thing for people to worry about, and US lawmakers spent time that they were getting paid for in an attempt to legislate this issue. The idea being that with commercial spaceflight becoming a thing, they want to ensure that no one messes up this historical imprint. For this reason, lawmakers tried to pass a bill making the moon landing site a national park. This failed, though NASA has asked people to at least attempt to respect the original lunar landing site, should they somehow end up there. Number 7. Spaceship Moon Theory. Maybe it's a god, maybe it's a huge chunk of cheese in the sky, or maybe it's an alien spaceship. The moon has been the victim of many strange origin stories over the years. Perhaps the oddest theory is that the moon is the remains of an alien spaceship that is left orbiting the Earth. The theory starts with the supposition that aliens have been seen on the surface of the moon. At one point, the United States even experimented with remote viewing, although they decided it was pure rubbish. What a surprise! But it gets even weirder. Those who subscribe to the theory claim that the moon's deposits of rocks, such as chromium, titanium, and zirconium, were actually because they were strong building materials for the aliens' enormous spaceship. Those who believe this claim that the moon's surface is actually armor plating and was used to protect it from meteorite impacts, although they believe that the moon has been abandoned for some time. Now, just before we get into the top 5 today, I do want to take a moment to tell you about today's sponsor, CuriosityStream. CuriosityStream is a subscription streaming service that offers over 2,000 documentaries and non-fiction titles from some of the world's best filmmakers, including exclusive originals. If you're enjoying this video and the subject matter, then I'd particularly recommend you check out their series, Return to the Moon, which is a great documentary. It's nearly an hour long, and it basically looks at how we as humanity are going to return to the moon and potentially even set up a permanent colony there. It's a great watch, and if you're enjoying this video, I think it's something you'll really enjoy as well. CuriosityStream is available on many platforms: web app, Roku, Android, Xbox One, smart TV. The list really does go on, and it's available worldwide. Get unlimited access starting at just $2.99 a month, and for you guys, the first 30 days are completely free. Just sign up at curiositystream.com/TopTenz and use the promo code TopTenz during the sign up process. That's a great way to support the show, keeps us making more videos, and I think CuriosityStream is a really great fit because they're about educational content as well. And let's get into the top 5. Number 6. Moonquakes. Over 40 years ago, while visiting the moon, astronauts left seismometers that sent data back to scientists waiting on good old terra firma for results. These seismometers were left active for over a decade, and now, many years later, a professor from Notre Dame and his team set to work once again looking at the data. What they found is that the moon has earthquakes, or moonquakes as it were. Apparently, there are several different kinds of quakes that can happen on the moon. The first are hundreds of miles below the surface. Some are simply vibrations set off by meteorites striking the surface. Still others are simply due to thermal expansion. And then there are the shallow moonquakes, the ones that, according to scientists, we need to watch out for. These are only tens of miles below the surface and can reach a 5.5 on the Richter scale. However, quakes on the moon have some features that differ from ours and make them more intense. Many of these shallow moonquakes went on for a good 10 minutes, and the researcher in charge said the moon was ringing like a bell. Learning more about these quakes is very important if any country is to ever set up a base on the moon. Number 5. The Man in the Moon. Long ago, before all our precious modern technology, man looked up at the moon and wondered about it. For one thing, what was the strange outline that looked like a man on the surface? Wanting to explain the strange shape, people made up different stories about the man in the moon. While these stories have different variations, they usually feature a man who has banished the moon as punishment for working on the Sabbath, and some versions include a woman who was punished with him for a similar crime. However, some legends suggest that the man was actually Cain, exiled to our lonely moon as punishment because his offering was not pleasing to God. Number 4. Moon Base. Suggesting that NASA will build a base on the moon has turned into almost something of a joke in the US. NASA keeps talking about it, and people keep making plans or claiming it's going to happen. It just never seems to get off the ground. However, while the United States may have been the first to land on the moon, they may not be the first to establish a permanent base there. Supposedly, the Russians plan to head to the moon with some cosmonauts in 2025 and hope to establish a base a few years later. But there are also the countries of Japan, China, and India close on their heels. China especially has ambitious plans of their own and has come up with advanced concepts for their own plans to establish a fully working moon base by the year 2050. Number 3. Blue Moon. You've probably at some point in your life heard the expression "once in a blue moon," and thus know it means something that doesn't happen very often. However, interestingly, there is some confusion as to how not often a blue moon actually occurs. Some people are under the impression that it is when two full moons happen in the same exact month, but this isn't accurate. Essentially, a blue moon is where a particular season has four full moons instead of three. Much more interesting, though, is that under certain circumstances, the moon can appear to be blue to the naked eye. According to scientists, volcanic eruptions can cause huge plumes of ash to spread out over the atmosphere and scatter red light particles. Particularly strong eruptions, such as the volcano Krakatoa, caused people to see blue moons and lavender suns for literally years. According to some people, as recently as the 1980s, after the Mount St. Helens eruption, a blue moon was visible in some parts of the world. Number 2. Outer Space Treaty. We mentioned earlier that one lawmaker tried to have the lunar landing site made into a national park, but it turns out there is a really good reason why this legislation failed. It may not be obvious to those outside the United States at first, but the moon is not actually US property. The moon orbits the Earth and is not claimed in particular by any one group of people. This presents a unique problem when it comes to colonizing, mining from, or even landing on the moon. Many years back, during the Cold War, some people were afraid that the moon might end up as a serious point of contention, perhaps even used as a military base or a place to launch missiles. After much diplomatic back and forth, a treaty was finally agreed upon that essentially makes the moon international territory, from which no one is allowed to conduct any military operations. Number 1. Dark Side of the Moon. You've probably heard the phrase "dark side of the moon" before. After all, it was one of Pink Floyd's most well-known albums. What you might not realize, though, is that the phrase actually doesn't make any sense. You see, the moon is mysterious and has a whole secret life that we know nothing about, and by that we mean there is a half of the moon we never see. However, while the moon only shows one side to us, it still shows both sides to the sun, and the dark side gets plenty of light. Interesting, if you take this the other way around, it means that if you looked at the Earth from the surface of the moon, you would end up with the same effect. The Earth would continue to show you the same side and remain in the same place in the sky every single night. So I really hope you found that video interesting. If you did, please do hit that thumbs up button below. Don't forget to subscribe. Brand new videos every day of the week. For more from me, why not check out my podcast? It's called The Brain Food Show. If you search "brain food," one word, wherever you get your podcasts, you will find it. If you like this sort of video, that's a little more of a casual format, so hope you find it interesting. And as always, thank you for watching.